There's reason to believe that industry pipelines are improving, as indicated in the spike of last year's number of FDA approvals and the likelihood that 2012 will continue along this trend. Analysts commenting for this year's pipeline report seemed impressed by the level of progress some companies are making in R&D and in the amount of partnering activity that's happening between big pharma and biotech to bring new products forward. The era of the blockbuster may be in decline, but it's not over yet. Many of the pipeline candidates profiled in this year's report are anticipating billion-dollar sales if approved. The pipeline report covers around 40 mid to late stage drug candidates, but I wanted to single out a couple of these products and new mechanisms as examples of emerging therapies that look exciting to patients and companies alike. The first group is the PCSK9 inhibitors, which are monoclonal antibody candidates and developed for very high cholesterol levels. Sanofi and Regeneron are developing one of these called alirocumab, which has entered phase 3 trials, and Amgen has a PCSK9 inhibitor known as AMG-145, which is also in phase 3. Both products are still a couple of years out from an approval decision, but are getting blockbuster whispers already from some analysts. Next, Pfizer's tofacitinib, brand name Xeljanz, received FDA approval earlier this week on Election Day and is the first oral JAK inhibitor approved for treating rheumatoid arthritis. The drug is expected to compete directly against the anti-TNF class, which includes huge blockbuster drugs like Abbott's Humira, and offers similar efficacy but the convenience of an oral administration. Abbott evidently sees oral therapies as the future of treatment in this category as well, or at least a strong alternative to the sub-Q anti-TNFs. The drug division of Abbott, soon to be known as AbbVie, paid handsomely for an option to license an oral JAK inhibitor known as GLPG0634 from the Belgium-based research firm Galapagos. That drug is currently in phase 2, but could challenge Pfizer's Xeljanz if it gets to market, according to some analysts. In prostate cancer, Bayer has partnered with the Norwegian biotech Algeta to develop a radium-223 chloride product to be called Alpharetin in Europe and Xofigo in the U.S., which employs a radioactive isotope that acts as a calcium mimic targeting bone metastases without affecting normal bone marrow. Since between 70 and 95% of prostate cancer patients suffer from bone metastases, as well as 75% of breast cancer patients and 40% of lung cancer patients, this product, if it works, could cover a lot of ground in the cancer space. To read about these products in further detail and many others across several of the most active therapeutic areas, look out for PharmExec's pipeline report